Jesus then asked him, "What is your name?" He said, "Legion." In the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. What is your pain? What is your anger? What is your fear? Notice I didn't say, are you hurting? Are you angry? Are you afraid? That's because pain, anger, and fear, they are just part of the human condition. Rene Descartes said, "I think, therefore I am." But he just could have easily have said, "I feel, therefore I am." In fact, that might have been closer to the truth. So what is your pain? Your name? Your fear? What are you doing to it, and what is it doing to you? We are created in God's image as creatures of deep feeling. Our feelings are so deep, not just pain and anger and fear, love, pride, joy, and war, that often those feelings are simply overwhelming, overpowering our rational selves, and with them our illusions of security, of control over our lives. There is a rawness to human emotion. There is a rawness to our pain, our anger, our fear. They can scare us in ourselves, and they can scare us in each other. They are so scary that often, far too often, we try to pretend that they're not there. We bury them deep down inside. We shove them deep into a closet. We pretend that everything is just fine. And when we do that, we create a lie that imprisons all of us, because we look at everyone else, and they seem to have it all together. No pain, no anger, no fear, I don't see any. We look at everyone else and they seem to have it all together, and we believe a lot that something is wrong with us. That our pain, our anger, our fear, that we're the only one who has it. We don't want to be different. We don't want to be weak, which is what it feels like. And so we pretend. We pretend for each other, and we pretend for ourselves. We pretend that we've got it all together. We pretend that the pain, the anger, the fear, we pretend that they aren't there. We pretend because we don't want to be different. We pretend because we don't want to be cast out. We try to bury them deep. They don't go away. They become the untreated wound that never heals, the loneliness that never feels a loving touch, the chasm between us that is never bridged, the awful truth that is never told. We try to bury them deep, but they don't go away. Sometimes when we are too tired to keep them down, they burst out, attaching themselves to whatever has brought them out. Sometimes when we are confronted with a person or an action or a situation that triggers that pain, that anger, that fear in us, those feelings just burst out. And they burst out in ways that divide us one from another, building walls and casting out. They burst out in ways that turn us against one another, preemptive strikes against these reminders of our own hidden humanity. They can burst out in a sharp word or a caustic evil. They can burst out in fight. They can burst out in flight. The extreme, the pain, the anger, the fear can burst out as they did at that Pulse nightclub in Orlando a week ago this morning. And always when they burst out, they divide and they multiply. The outbursts, large and small, the demonizations and spewing of venom, they divide us one from another. They multiply the pain, the anger, the fear, and they perpetuate the lie that we're on our own, that we're not all in this together. They perpetuate the lie that indeed we are not made for each other, that we do not need each other, that indeed we are not each other's salvation. What is our pain? What is our pain? What is our fear? What are we doing to it, and what is it doing to us? Do we dare to name it? Do we dare to feel it? Do we dare to believe that it could be healed? This morning we hear the story of Jesus meeting a man who has many demons. We are not told what they are, but it is clear from his cries that he is in deep, deep pain. It is clear from his broken shackles that he was incredibly angry, and it is clear from how he had been cast out of his community, sent to live in the tombs, that he was someone of whom everyone else was very, very afraid. And Jesus, God made human, the love of the divine, come to be with us, to live with us, to feel with us, approaches him. And at first, Jesus is too much for the man to bear. In the face of great pain, great anger, great fear, love, or even the possibility of love is often too much for us to bear, because love demands that we look our pain, our anger, our fear full in the face. Love demands that we drag them out of their closet, pull them out of their depths. Love demands that we acknowledge them, that we feel, that we give them their turn. Love demands that we confront the lies that our pain, our anger, our fear so often convince us to believe. Terrible lies about our own unlovability. But lies that nonetheless have become the country we have grown so accustomed to inhabit. Jesus, the love of all loves, walks up to this man of pain, of anger, the man who inspires such great fear, not because he's the only one with demons, but because he reminds others their demons. Jesus, the love of all loves, walks up to this man, and he asks him just one question. What is your name? Jesus walks up to the man and says, what is your name? He's really asking, what is your pain? What is your anger? What is your fear? The man says the name, Legion, many. I have so much pain. I have so much anger. I have so much fear. My name is Legion. Saying that one word, Legion, this naked, outcast man shows himself to be a person of the deepest courage. For in saying that one word, Legion, he is owning and naming his pain, his anger, his fear. In saying that one word, Legion, he allows the process of liberation. We are in a time of great changes, and we've been there for quite a while. The pace of technological, social, and political change in our lifetimes has perhaps been greater than any time in human history. In our nation, and even around the world, the past decade, and particularly the past several years, have seen movements of liberation that are blessedly taking these structures of society that have long imprisoned people underprivileged because of skin color and gender and sexual orientation and countless other categories, and breaking these structures apart, but not without huge backlashes that in their pain and anger done things to wound and anger each other. The massacre of our lesbian, gay, bisexual, and transgender siblings in a place that was supposed to be a sanctuary has wounded and angered us. I know some of you feel wounded by me and by some of the changes that are happening here at Christ Church Cathedral. There's nothing I can say to change that, and the last thing I want to do is to tell you that you shouldn't feel that way. That is the opposite of what I want to tell you this morning. The change that is before us is deeply unsettling, and fear is not unexpected. The pain, the anger, the fear, these are incredibly natural. They are incredibly human. We feel, therefore we are. The last thing I want to do is to tell you that you should feel. For if I have learned one thing from our time together, it is that you've got to feel to heal. But I do know that feeling is hard. I do know that we feel so deeply that it is sometimes too much. So deeply that we are tempted to pretend that we don't feel at all and hope the feelings just go away. So deeply that we are tempted to turn against one another. So deeply that we are tempted to build walls and to fire arrows, hoping that if we can cast out or defeat an enemy, that the pain, the anger, the fear will depart as well. And I'm here to tell you, that road leads nowhere good. That road leads to the tombs where the man with his demons rage and moan. That road leads to nothing but death. But there is good news. Because as much as we are tempted to shrink away or lash out in the midst of our pain, our anger, our fear, Jesus does not shrink away from or lash out at us. Jesus walks right up to us, seeing the pain and the anger and the fear. Impervious to our attempts to conceal it from one another, from Jesus, and even from ourselves, Jesus walks right up to us and asks us a question that is three in one. What is your name? What is your pain? What is your anger? What is your fear? Can we name it? Can we have the courage of the man who had been relegated to the place of the dead? Can we have the courage to name our pain, to name our anger, to name our fear? Can we have the courage not just to look not just Jesus, but one another, full in the face? Building walls and firing arrows, saying, I'm hurting. I'm angry. I'm afraid. I'm wondering if maybe you are too. Pain, the anger, the fear can be so overpowering. But in Christ, can we meet in that place? Can we try to feel them together? Not shrinking away from feeling deeply ourselves, but also holding each other gently. As we do the same, not turning against each other, but turning toward each other. In Christ and through Christ, again, we have that grace, that power, that courage. Today's gospel tells us, yes, we can. There were so many responses to the massacre at Pulse last Sunday morning that moved my heart this week. But among them were two I want to share with you, because they each speak to how much we struggle with the rawness and depth of what we're feeling right now, and how hard it is to live together in the midst of it. One was from Gerasene, a beautiful transgender man and co-owner of Left Bank Books, if you know Jared. Jared wrote, it's as if every human in every group is screaming, recognize my pain! It's so hard to recognize and care for someone else's pain when you're in it too. Let's all be gentle and patient with each other. And when we're not able to be gentle and patient, let's recognize that as a reaction to pain and not an indictment of our character. In my language of faith, I hear the word Sharon described as grace. Let's have grace. It's holding each other with unmerited love. Loving, whether or not that love is returned. And with that on my heart, I read these words from the Episcopal Bishop of Pittsburgh, Gerasene, that reminded me that the grace what Jared is talking about is not something that we need to wish for. It's all ours in Jesus. Here's what Bishop McConnell says. We would understand that the problem is this. We fear our own death more than we love the lives of others. Because we fear, we put our sins on someone else's head. We push them away. We kill in the hope that we will finally find peace. But the saints, in their silence, know what we can only believe. That the peace we are looking for has been already won in the cross of Christ. No further sacrifice is needed or allowed. No scapegoat. No end. This morning's gospel reading is not a story about some poor soul. It is not even a story of there but for the grace of God go I. The story of the Gerasene demoniac is our story. Each of us and all of us. What is our name? Our name is Legion. And this story is the story of our and of our fear. It is the story of the power of that pain, anger, and fear to tear us apart inside and to rip us apart from one another. But ultimately, it is the story of how Jesus, the love beyond all love, meets us in the midst of it, invites us to name it, stands with us as we feel it, turns us not away from each other, draws us toward each other and meets all of us together in a loving and healing grace. What is our name? What is our anger? What is our fear? What are you doing to it? What is it doing to you? Do we dare to name it? Do we dare? Do we dare to believe that in Christ